So welcome again to lecture 6. In this lecture we are talking about strain gauge arrangements. So when the strain gauge are used in measurements, especially for stress measurements, it is important to understand the state of stress. State of stress on which the beam or the body is under. So when you talk about arrangement, these are cases or the states in which the strain gauge is being used to measure. So the first arrangement, I'll call it case one, is what I would call as the uniaxial. Uniaxial state. Okay. So, if I may use a sketch, what happens is we will have a beam subjected to stresses only in the x direction, like that. And then the strain gauge be mounted there. So this is the strain gauge. Okay. So the only stress is the sigma xx. And in this case, the strain gauge is positioned along the is located coincident with the x-axis, and the stress in this case, this stress is determined as such, where this is the Young modulus and this is the strain in that direction. Therefore, in this case, the Hooke's law, okay, the Hooke's law holds. The second case, now case two, is the isotropic state. What happens in this case? The body is subjected to the same stress in other axis. So that stress is equals to that. Okay. So the stress at any given point is that. Any point. So the x, x, y, the y direction is the same as that strain, okay, and is the same as the principal stresses, and in this case there is no shear stresses. So the strain gauge can be placed in any direction. For instance, it could be so this could be now the strain gauge. Okay, then I go alpha there. Okay, so how do we determine the stress? The stress in this case is determined as that. I'm sure these are equations from your solid mechanics, solid and structural mechanics. Okay. The third state, case three, is the case of pure torsion. Okay. So in this case, the body is subjected to torsion T. Okay, subjected to torsion T, and what happens is the strain gauge will be located at an angle of 45. So this is 45 degrees, given that the shear strain. This is the shear strain is given as such. So this is where the strain gauge will be located, around 45 degrees. And as you can see, there is no normal stress. It's only the torsion which is present. And in this case, the shear stress is determined as where this is the shear modulus and this is the shear strain. Again, the Hooke's law for shear works at that point. Okay. So those three cases, we have discussed the three basic cases. So a recap of the three basic cases. One, the uniaxial. Stress, which the stress acts along one axis only. The other one is isotropic, in which the state of stress at any point is the same, and the third one is a pure torsion, which the body is purely under torsion, that, and there are no normal stresses. So thank you.